So if you remember an elliptic case.
Yeah, an elliptic case, yeah, the fraction will occur.
Yeah.
No, an elliptic case usually have non-quantum. Non-quantum, so you have a non-quantum family, let's say. Non-quantum family, the fraction occurs. So therefore, it cannot be. So therefore, because the normal part here is coming from the base. So the total, there are no multipliers along the base. I think that's correct, maybe. At least, yeah. That's what I got from some question. So the multipliers usually create multiple fibers, is not single, not usually. Even source code is multiple source code given one way. It's all effect. It's about four. You know, you receive four, and there is something. So multiple means all fibers are multiple, yeah. Okay, so the existence of a common multiple means you have this property. That's what okay, so therefore we have more multiple fibers in this scheme. Oops. Hopefully it's correct. Let's see what the result is. In fact, I must say, I'm convinced that this should. First, I'm convinced that we don't have to go beyond the four-dimensional pushing point. Because if you have some stuff, so because you know how to say, I think you can control it. For example, over a neighborhood of a surface, there are plenty of rational curves. If you have a reasonable rational surface, then we can suppose there is a detour inside which doesn't intersect. So then I think we can get it. But it's just a thought. And the second is that if you have co-dimension two, then if you take a section, then you again have, for the same reason, you have this one of these quotient singularities. On the fiber, the only problem here, which I think, as usual, I'm very optimistic about, but as usual, you know, we can't kind of get the same statement of the rank of the rank of F can be bigger. That's the question, that's the problem. However, there is a small error. The remedy is that, in fact, you know, if you have a, so suppose you take a surface, so suppose you have a, suppose you have, so these are singularity of four-dimensional. Yes, then there is this, we take tangent space to the singularity. And then to the tangent space in the singularity, there will be corresponding sub-vector fields on the fiber. Normally, a trivial vector bound where the action of your group G is trivial. Yeah, so therefore I suspect that it integrates. So therefore your variety, in fact, is isogenous. So this fiber, generic fiber, is isogenous to, let's say, degeneration. In that sense, okay, two cross something like that. So therefore, it will reduce again to the rank. But that's just a guess. You know, we didn't complete it yet. And also, I think in higher dimensional singularities, you will also have something like quotient singularity, though it's not something like that. So I think in general, yeah, for top dimensional singularity, we also have quotient singularity, Cn by G, C, but the A minus K by G. Yes, sir. Dimension of the transversal space, Cn minus K. So I think it is also going to be the circling, the quotient at the center, and the local is transversal is subject. But I think it's more than that, it is G. So that G means G, not identity, G has not eigenvalue 1. Which means X free. And there is also groups, so there are not that many groups. And in fact, these groups are essentially some relatively simply constructed P groups and the group dimension group. So in fact, I suspect that the whole theory can be reduced to very relatively few F in the single points. So maybe, even though they may be it may not be N, but something very close. Okay, that's all what I want to say. I wanted to add something about the voice, but that may take too long. Okay, thank you. I didn't tell you, but I told everybody that I'm dead now. So if someone wants to ask any questions, come on, I can do it.
I have a question.
I can do it, right?
Any questions?
No, actually, I don't do it. Yeah, but some people are here, some people not. So, what's up?
What about the Casper format? Is it a little tricky? Because I'm trying to Casper hybrid data format.
Well, I think Lagrangian is Lagrangian integration.
It's
Lagrangian integration, I think we can.
Yeah. What is the symmetric one? What is the symmetric one?
I don't know. My problem is that actually, this question occurred in a conversation, and then I answered it, and then we started to write this. But you've worked in the field for some time, so I'm not. And I have to look through many articles. And I actually plan to do it after semester ends.
How about existence of Lagrangian? Existence of Lagrangian in general. Is there any problem to prove the existence of Lagrangian?
Well, I'll say at the moment, the best results I know, I hope at least, it's not that I looked through the literature. I remember that Bilditsky proved something about if you have a class which is kind of D to the N is trivial, and the divisor, then there's a torus. There is a kind of torus where it benches completely, the form which benches. But torus is not that top-dimensional. If it would be top-dimensional, then. So in principle, then there are something about the currents and some many results. There are many results, but it's difficult to even a third-dimensional answer. I can't do it. But there is some about uniqueness of some kind of limit, positive current, and so this is this kind of result.
or non-compact version. Non-compact version, but non-compact application.
I don't think there is any. Yeah, no, I don't know any. There are many constructions, but open and so. That's another. Kind of, this is an area of the compact curve. It's kind of close to main transition. Because two things need to do is just to deform to a Lagrangian and then look at Lagrangian. Which essentially, you look at something, if you look at BN, you look at devices which are found the degree, degeneration devices are found the degree, so it all looks kind of doable. So maybe my first guess was not that far, so that they exist, but actually, like, I think. Any other questions?
If not, there's no question for the
world. Yeah, okay.
By the way, there's a dinner tonight at 7 p.m. in Royal East.
It's what you mean, I'm leaving until tomorrow.
So, on the shop, I know, it's kind of
nevertheless,
we have this is up. So this is a theorem. Now then together with this is supposed to give me together with Giambi and Bonacci, there's basically the same theorem by an equivalent with Marzo, and it's basically a weighted version of your Mathis in resolution similarities result. It's still 36-0. Everything here is in 36-0 today. So there is a procedure, I call it F, associated with a single sum variety, so you X is a single sum variety of a smooth variety Y, so I'm doing a better resolution. Associated with a single variety of center, I need to tell you what the center is. With associated going up, I need to tell you what the going up is. And the proper transform is, so the proper transform of X is X5, such that the maximum similarity back of X5 is slightly smaller than the maximum back of X. This is what Michael jumped in, Michael, I'm also doing algorithm. You don't need to know anything about what you've done before. Take a variety, amend this new variety, look for express locus, do the right thing there, and it gets better. The dream algorithm. In particular, for some hand, it will have to stop because I haven't told you about the invariants live inside the available of the Z, and therefore it will stop. I think this is what everyone wanted from the beginning, but knowing about the big number of people gave up.
Yeah.
Okay. On the other hand, there's a colleague. Oh, this I don't know how to start from shutting up. There's a colleague in France, Bernard Desir, who says whose advice about resolution singularity is when you have a single variety, approach it gently and ask politely how it wants to be blown up, and maybe the variety will tell you. Okay, so the answer is good, right? So I need to explain all the red stuff here, and probably more than the red stuff. As I said, okay, I said this is the dream of it. So procedure here means a functor. You need to say which, oh, you got a question.
No.
You need to say which, on which category. Functor on which category. So this, or maybe just move over for some reason. On which category, I moved the cursor. I moved the cursor, maybe that's...
But it's not sure, does it not show on the wall?
No.
Oh.
It did show just a few minutes ago, so I did something wrong.
It's what?
Yes, we go. Oh, wait. Oh, there we go. Okay. So a functor of smooth surjective morphism. So the category is the smooth variety Y with smooth surjective morphism. So this says if I have a smooth surjective map from Y onto Y, then what I do on the pullback is a pullback of what I do on Y. This has huge implications. In particular, you never pass the smooth locus, because the smooth locus is obtained by taking a map to the point, and you never blow up the point because there's no
smooth. Why is smooth or not?
They have, so the smooth, the Hamming variety is always smooth.
Ah, okay, good.
Always smooth.
And then what is smooth? Okay.
Ah, I see. Okay, so I told you what procedure means. I need to tell you what invariants are, what centers are, and what blowing up means in my context. So I'll give you a preview, and only later I'll give you a definition, because I want to show you that in the example it actually works. So I'll give you a preview and show you that it works in the example. So give you an invariant. For a point in my variety X, and we find a number associated to the point, we put some in, just nothing very inventive. It sits inside the well-known subset of the set of sequences of positive rational numbers. So the subset is well-known, and we prove this is actually in a previous paper. We prove that this is lexicographically other semi-continuous. And further, if I have a smooth point,